play first. Oh yeah, we're snapping this one off. It seems bad, but if I draw an island, then it becomes, I think, decent because I get to go commit and then trial of knowledge and have some cartouches to back things up. Naga Vitalist into island would be pretty nice, though. Also, just like drawing like medium green cards are fine. And I have a lot of cyclers, so I'm not super worried about this draw. Though I guess I am kind of getting punished for... Ooh, Watch and Log. That was a great draw. For not playing... For playing 9 forests and 8 islands. Watch of the Dead. That card is not particularly good. Alright. Well, this draw has worked out quite nicely, because now I get to go Watchful Naga into, like, either cartouche to make sure it lives through combat, exert, draw a card. And my opponent is hopefully not killing it. And let's see, Doom Dissenter, and then probably no attacks. Alright, how big do I want to go? Because I could go Cartouche of Knowledge, attack, and draw, but I think that option's going to be available later. Let's just go Trial of Knowledge. And then I can return it with the cartouche. I'm just going to draw all the cards this game. Discard a card. I actually don't want to discard a land because I feel like... I think I'm discarding the Greater Sandworm. Because I feel like when I'm drawing millions of cards, not hitting land drops is one way to lose. I could have discarded Zenith Seeker as well. But that one also seems fine. This is a dangerous card to have out. When you have this out, your opponent really has incentive to lead back blockers, so it's a pretty cool effect that it has. Alright, I'll take 2 from the Meowcats, and see what we got. Soul Stinger. Counters on Doom Dissenter, getting a 4/5 out of the deal. Jeez. Alright, well. I could use Commit to Memory. I might just draw some cards here. +1 flying, draw a card, exert. I get to return the trial as well. I am going to attack and exert. And hopefully draw like a card to play here. Another trial of knowledge, alright. So now I'm probably just going to... I was really hoping to draw an island here. But I think I'm just going to go Cartouche of Strength. And then fight the stupid cat. Because now I get to, if I draw an island, go Floodwaters. Yeah, sure. My opponent got to exile their cat instead for some reason. I can go Floodwaters on Soulstinger and the zombie. Liliana, Death's Majesty? Alright. Island would be really good now. Just not draw an island. Land. I mean, I can use Commit to Memory to put Liliana 2 from the top. And then cycle Floodwaters. Can also just put the Soul Stinger 2 from the top and then attack Liliana next turn, but it's not going to be for lethal. Or I can just Cartouche of Strength down the Soul Stinger, I guess. Yeah. And then I should cycle Floodwaters, I suppose. And I might actually need to cast both. This is all ending up so awkwardly. Alright, let's draw the island. I could actually take 1,000,000 damage and set it up next turn. No, let's just go Cartouche of Strength. Fight Soul Stinger. And it has no counters, so that doesn't matter. Okay. So now, my opponent's going to tick Liliana up to 7, but I can attack Liliana for 5 in the air, and I will not be exerting the Watchful Naga at that point. And then I can Floodwaters back the 2 zombies, or whatever else my opponent plays. What did my opponent just do? Oh, yeah, because they milled themselves for 2, sure. Lord of the Accursed? Alright, well, I guess that's a thing. Alright, so I go to 9. Or take 6, or rather go to 6. So I have Floodwaters. And I guess I attack Liliana, and then I attack down to one. Alright. And then next turn, I'm committing to memory the Lord of the Accursed, and then blocking. Well, let's see. So for this to work, my opponent has to basically play nothing, and I have to, like, draw a reasonable card. Cycle the Wasteland Scorpion. That's a great sign for me. Let's see what you got. Cartouche. Alright, that will do it. Alright. I could put in Cancel against Liliana. Don't love that answer. Lay Claim is a good answer to Liliana. Alright. I guess let's battle. Alrighty, time for game two. I would like to play first. Alright. This is a good hand. I've got stuff going on here. I get to play either Hecma Sentinels or Watchful Naga into Trial of Knowledge and then follow up with a Colossipede. Naga Vitalist? No, Cartouche of Knowledge. Not quite. So if I don't draw another land, I probably should just play the Watchful Naga to guarantee that I hit. Or not guarantee, make it more likely that I hit another land here. Plus, if my opponent doesn't play a blocker, maybe I get to snipe in for a hit here. And seems unlikely, but you never know. Mouth to Feed, so it makes a 3-3 hippo, and then draw a card for each. Yeah, alright, well, let's go Cartouche of Knowledge. Draw. Attack, and I will be exerting. Draw. And then I get to go Colossipede into Floodwaters or Colossipede into Cartouche of Strength. Both are pretty good. Humph. And pass. I'm not going to be cycling Floodwaters here. Alright. Don't mind this. See what my opponent plays here. Soul Stinger, I guess, would be a thing. Even if they kill Watchful Naga, I got an extra card out of the deal. Alright, what do we got? Edifice of Authority. Well, I guess Manglehorn is coming in. I can tell you that much. Because now my opponent's played two artifacts, and one of them's very good. This starts creatures from attacking and eventually makes them unable to attack or block. Whoa, they did not use it? They bricked? Or didn't brick, as it were? Because now they don't have an extra counter on this. Alright. That's not exactly the play you want to make. Soul Stinger. This is fine. So what do I do now? Good Floodwaters those two. That actually seems pretty good because that kills the hippo, bounces the Soul Stinger. My opponent then makes Watchful Naga unable to attack. And then I can follow up with Hecma Sentinel's Cartouche of Strength next turn. Alright, and attack for 5. And if their best play is to replay Soul Stinger, I'm not super worried. I've also got 2 copies of Trial of Knowledge in my hand, so it's not a great blocker. Ooh, Crocodile of the Crossing, interesting. So, if we make some Watchful Naga unable to attack, Colossipede still gets basically a free attack. So I'm not even going to use the Cartouche of Strength here, so I'm just going to go to attack and see what my opponent says. Okay, Watchful Naga unable to attack. Colossipede sending it in. Opponent wants to chump and then move 2 counters onto something. Okay, Colossipede now. 3-3 with 2 damage on it. I'm going to play Trial of Knowledge and hope to draw a land here. Did not draw a land. Alright, I'm going to discard Trial of Knowledge. I think we're probably getting excessive if we keep that. Then I'll just play Naga Vitalist. I still like the spot I'm in. Now I have 7 mana, so I can play 2 interactive spells. I can play Commit and Cartouche of Strength if I want. I can also Crocodile of Crossing, put the counter on the Naga Vitalist, and then Cartouche of Strength. So Quarry Hollow, so they can put another counter on the Colossal Feed, sure. Make it into a 2-2. I'm going to go Crocodile of the Crossing. Yeah, so let's do this. Put a counter on that. The Naga Vitalist, and then go Cartouche of Strength on Crocodile of the Crossing. Fight the Quarry Hauler. My opponent uses Edifice to make the Crocodile unable to attack, presumably. And then I even get my Trial of Knowledge back, and then Watchful Naga and Colossal Feed get to get in there. I actually don't think I'm exerting Watchful Naga either. Far be it for me to turn down a card, but Supernatural Stamina, that's bad, because now, no, I definitely don't want to fight then. All right, at least that's good, because if this dies, it returns the battlefield tapped. So I guess I didn't have to fight there, so that at least worked out a little bit. All right, so now no attacks, though, because this still has the Supernatural Stamina effect. Okay, and then next turn I still have Commit if I would like, and I can also just keep playing creatures. So I'm already ahead on board a decent amount. Also, end of turn I can go, like, Commit your Edifice of Authority and then attack, have free reign to attack, which is pretty nice. Especially if my opponent leaves mana up for Edifice, that is great. Watchers of the Dead. And Lord of the Accursed. Sure. Let's see if my opponent lets me attack. Probably tapping the Watchful Naga down, or essentially locking it down. And then I could attack with the Crocodile of the Crossing. My opponent would have to double block. Doesn't sound too bad. It even has trample, so it'll get an extra point of damage in. Block the Watchers and the Quarry Hauler. Yeah, that's true. And then I can also use Commit if my opponent... I'm going to block with those two, sure. I think I just trade, though. And then... let's just play more gigantic things. And then... I just run my opponent over with Colossipedes and Crocodiles and whatnot. Hecma Sentinels also is going to attack as like a 4-5, potentially. And let's see... opponent has to have something pretty big here. Shefet Monitor, 6-5. And that's technically large, yeah, sure. I'm going to play this pre-combat so my Hecma Sentinels get a little bit better. Yield to that. And... to attack. See, now my opponent, they might lock down the Watchful Naga, but then I get to put Shefet Monitor 2 from the top and then attack with Colossipedes. To actually attack with all these things. Opponent blocks the 2-2 Colossipede. I probably don't cycle the River Serpent since it's just gigantic. And then pass, and at some point I could cast Memory. I mean, if I have millions of lands in play, each player drawing 7 cards isn't that bad. Alright, opponent is dead, and I'm putting in Manglehorn. Destroying an artifact seems great. What am I mangling, though? I could take Bitterblade Warrior out. Who needs early plays, huh? Yeah. No, actually, that's bad. I'm going to keep Bitterblade Warrior, I'm going to take Xena Seeker out. That's got to be a little bit better. Alrighty, time for game 3. Pretty solid hand. Hecma Sentinels into Crocodile or Trial of Knowledge. Naga Vitalist, still the best card I could draw. Ooh, Watchful Naga, not bad. Though. Uh-oh. Turn 2, 3-1. I'm going to lose to the stupid cat? I might. Actually, I might. Into Cursed Minotaur? What? Where did this all come from? Oy, all right. I guess I'm going to play Watchful Noga. Now I draw the Bitterblade Warrior? Just mocking me at this point. Actually, let's play Hecma Sentinels. I think I'd rather... No. I'll play the Naga. I think I'd rather trade off the Naga at this point than the Hecma Sentinels. I think the later the game goes, the more useful Hecma Sentinels is going to be. Alright. Definitely have to block here. Alright. Opponent has a trick. Yeah. Shed weakness, sure. +2/+2. And we got a 14. More beaters? No. River Serpent. Ooh. So now I can go Hecma Sentinels and then cycle River Serpent. Could get my opponent pretty nicely here. If they attack with that Initiate's Companion. Yeah. Alright. This is going to be Hecma good if it works. No! How dare you. Alright. I'm going to take it. Hope my opponent doesn't have too much of a follow-up and then play... Probably Crocodile with the Crossing. There goes Liliana, yeah. Mm, huh. Actually, we'll cycle this now since I do need to find something. Sure, let's go Crocodile with the Crossing. And... I'm just going to pass. I could attack with Crocodile, but I think my opponent's going to double block. And I really just need to draw blue cartouche or green cartouche to really get through here. If I do, I have a chance, but if I don't, then we are in trouble. Alright, so what are we looking to draw here? I guess, again, blue cartouche would be pretty good. I mean, I get to Trial of Knowledge, but on the draw, these are not as quite as good. Had I drawn Bitterblade Warrior on 2 instead of 3, then I would have taken a bunch left damage off the initiate's companion, and the Shed Weakness would not have traded for Watchful Naga. But at this point, Bitterblade Warrior is not doing a whole lot for me. Then again, my opponent doesn't have a great attack here, because if they don't have another trick, I get to Crocodile the Crossing is big enough to keep everything back. I feel like they maybe have a -1/-1 trick. I'm just going to block the Initiate's Companion here. Take 3, going to 8. And see what they got. A Mouth, making a 3/3 hippo, sure. And what else do we have here? Land. And Floodwaters. Okay. Floodwaters is a card, so I can bounce those two and attack Liliana. And my opponent can take it and pull me down to 3. But then I'm just hoping to draw either another Floodwaters or a green cartouche, or basically something that affects the board here. Of course, if I don't attack Liliana, she just can destroy all non-zombies and then I'm pretty dead. So I need my opponent to not play anything here, and me to draw a good card. They're tapping mana. This can't be good. Oh, they're flashing back Mouth to Feed to draw a card. Okay, that is acceptable. All right, again, no play anything, and then me draw Floodwaters. Forest, not quite. All right, let's play Trial of Knowledge. Draw. Lake Claim is interesting. Okay, so now let's play Bitterblade Warrior. Play a land, and I guess we're just dead because my opponent has a menace creature and some zombies. Alright. Look, I just consider these first couple Amonkhet drafts trials by knowledge, because now I'm learning a lot about what not to do or something like that. I don't know. Look, I'm trying to justify the fact that I'm just getting crushed. Okay, that does not matter. Yep, I'm still dead. Alright, well, that'll do it, and better luck next time.